Hey everyone, it is Van here again, and today I'm going to be counting down my top 5 worst Smash Bros. Maps. So let's jump right in. Starting my list out at number 5 is Gamer. This stage is inspired by the game Gamer in Game & Wario. In this stage, fighters battle it out on a table in a bedroom while trying to avoid being seen by the mom that comes to check in their room every once in a while. The only way to avoid the mom is to go behind one of the things on the stage, otherwise, you can get launched really far, and sometimes, if you are at a high enough percentage, this will even kill you. The stage's layout also changes every time, so you don't exactly know what to expect, so you blindly go in having no clue who will have the advantage no matter what character you choose. I know the mom coming into the room is part of the game in Wario game, Gamer, but for Smash Bros, it's just a really annoying stage hazard that nobody likes. While the mom ruins most of the stage as a stage hazard, I'm actually fine with the stage changing up a bit each time you play it, but if you are someone who actually likes knowing what they're getting themselves into, this is definitely not the stage for you. The Great Cave Offensive is a stage for 8-player Smash, but that does not help the fact that this is one of the few big maps in the game and it is almost impossible to see what the heck is going on. This stage is made because of specifically 8-player Smash, and I guess it makes sense that it exists, but when I play it, even if it is 8-player Smash, it's really confusing and annoying because you can never tell where you or anyone else is. To add to this, all of the areas are narrow, and if you launch someone, a lot of the time, will just bounce off the walls, leading to nothing. But that leads me to another thing. To fix this problem, they add lava panels to the wall, so if you hit it and you are over 100%, it's an instant death. The problem with this is if you are over 100% and accidentally hit one, you still die. I don't know if it's just me who thinks this is a problem, but nevertheless, I don't like this stage, and that's all there is to it. At number 3, we have another big stage. You guessed it, Palutena's Temple. This stage is a monster, and even if you are playing on 8-player Smash, it feels way too big. You can go and hide in the corner and wait for everyone else to battle it out and be the last one standing by doing absolutely nothing. Also, if you notice there is somebody coming after you, you can just run away and that almost always works. Matches on the stage can go on for a long time if you do not have a time limit set, because pretty much all matches on the stage consist of retreating and hiding. Once again, I understand that this mode is for 8-player Smash, but I feel that this stage is not even good for that. I feel if you could have a 15-player Smash, even that won't fill up the entire map. Unless you enjoy chasing your opponents around the map, I have no idea why anyone would play this one. I have never been a fan of games that side-scroll, and Pac-Land is no exception to that. Pac-Land is nothing but a side-scrolling stage with a bunch of things you have to jump over, otherwise you get caught on them and you're pretty much dead no matter what. I don't know what they were thinking when they made this stage because I do not know anyone who actually enjoys playing this stage. If you smash attack someone against the scroll of the screen, they're pretty much dead no matter what. Even at low percentages, they can still get killed pretty easily. I guess the fact that the stage itself just plays such a big role in whether someone is killed or not just bugs me. Even if you do like scroller levels, it's not fun effing jump over things and battle at the same time. Stage hazards are a big problem on the stage, and I just seem to hate every part of it. It's not a fun stage no matter what. Okay, I get stages based on retro games are cool, but that's no excuse for 75M. I don't exactly know what made them think this stage was a great idea, but it wasn't. Although it looks like a pretty cool stage, once you get on the dang map, there are stage hazards everywhere you go. Even the ladder gets in the way. If you are someone who uses tap jump like me, whenever you mean to jump, you always accidentally grab onto the ladder instead of actually jumping like you were meaning to. All of the platforms in the stage are really small, so if you're not a good aerial fighter, you're pretty much dead meat. It is a stage that is meant to be really cool, representing the old Donkey Kong game, but it's just a failed stage because they literally took the original stage and stuck it into the game. I feel they could have at least optimized it a little bit for Smash Bros, but nope. This stage is just annoying, and it is never fun earning itself the title of the worst Super Smash Bros. Stage. Okay guys, these have been my top 5 worst Super Smash Bros. Stages. Be sure to leave your top 5 worst Smash Bros. Stages in the comment section below. So yeah, thank you guys all for watching this video, I very much appreciate it. Be sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel, be sure to leave a like, that does very much support me. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and all the other social media description below. So yeah, thank you guys all for watching once again, I very much appreciate it, and as usual, bye!